Good morning, students. So this is the continuation of the lesson Physical Geography of Tamil Nadu. In the last class we saw about history of formation of the state of Tamil Nadu and the physiographic divisions. Now we are going to focus on the topics climate, soil, natural vegetation. Then what are the major natural disasters that occur in Tamil Nadu and what are the preventive measures? Now already I told you about the position of India. So India is situated in the tropics, hence we experience a tropical climate, and since we are getting rains from both the monsoons, India experiences tropical monsoon climate. The direct rays of the sun fall on India, hence India is quite hot throughout the year with the two monsoon rains we get seasonally. And Tamil Nadu has a very good coastline, so on the coastline or the coastal areas experience a maritime type of climate. The eastern coast of Tamil Nadu experiences maritime coast of climate, whereas the western side experiences a mountainous type of climate. And central Tamil Nadu, sometimes it gets rains, otherwise it is dry, and the temperature is very high because it is far away from the sea coast. Now the migration of the vertical rays of the sun is responsible for the different seasons Tamil Nadu experiences. So we have four different seasons: winter season, summer season, southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon. So first we are going to focus on the winter season, that is from January to February, 2 months of winter season. So at this time the vertical rays of the sun fall between the Tropic of Capricorn and the equator. So what happens, Tamil Nadu gets only the slanting rays of the sun, hence we experience a cold climate. The temperature is sometimes some 15 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius, and in some places in the mountain areas, for example in the Nilgiris, sometimes the temperature drops to 0 degrees. Some valleys also are affected because of this extreme cold climate, and they experience thick mist and frost. The summer season is caused by the migration of the sun towards the north, that is during the month of March, April and May. So the vertical rays of the sun fall over Tamil Nadu, so we experience very hot climate. So because of this there is a rise in the temperature, and since Tamil Nadu is to south of Tropic of Cancer, it experiences very high temperature. So the temperature ranges from 30 degrees Celsius to sometimes to 40 degrees Celsius. Sometimes during the month of May, Tamil Nadu receives a rainfall. It is called as mango showers. This is got from the convectional rainfall. Already you have learnt about the different types of rainfall. So it is the convectional rainfall Tamil Nadu experiences during the summer season. The southwest monsoon, this happens because of the heating of the landmass in the North India. Because of the low pressure in North India, it draws water from the Indian Ocean So the entire wind from the Indian Ocean moves towards the state, so we get the southwest monsoon. But during this southwest monsoon, since Tamil Nadu is located in the center, it is in the rain shadow region, so Tamil Nadu does not get that much of rain from southwest monsoon. But there are some areas in Tamil Nadu which receives very good rainfall. For example, Coimbatore. Always Kanyakumari receives heavy rainfall from both the monsoons. So Kanyakumari receives rainfall from both the monsoons because it is located in the southern tip of Tamil Nadu. Apart from Kanyakumari, Tirunelveli and Nilgiris also gets very good rainfall during the southwest monsoon, whereas the other parts of Tamil Nadu gets very less or scanty rainfall. The northeast monsoon season commences from the month of October till December. What happens during the northeast, how this occurs? High pressure is created over Central Asia, so northern part of India becomes a source for the northeast monsoon winds. So from the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn, migration happens. So there is a change in the receiving temperature and air pressure. So the winds blow towards the Bay of Bengal from North India and they get deflected and they start moving towards the Indian South India. Hence it is called as Northeast Monsoon Winds. It is a part of the retreating Southwest Monsoon Winds, so it is also called as retreating monsoons. So this is the main northeast monsoon, is the main rainy season for Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu gets very good rainfall from the northeast monsoon. Mainly the coastal areas of Tamil Nadu gets nearly some 60% of the rainfall. Coastal districts or the interior districts get nearly some 40 to 50% of the annual rainfall. And during these northeast monsoon, tropical cyclones occur originating from the Bay of Bengal. So these cyclones bring heavy rainfall to the state of Tamil Nadu. So the state receives lot of rain from the northeast monsoon and the cyclones that occur during this season. So the rainfall received by both this is nearly some 50 to 100 centimeter, and the cyclones sometimes affect the coastal areas. It causes lot of destruction to life and property. Next we move on to the topic soils. Soils in Tamil Nadu are broadly classified into according to their characteristics. So it is alluvial, black, red, laterite and saline soil. Already you might have learnt about the different types of soils, what are their characteristics. So we are going to see first about the alluvial soil. So in Tamil Nadu we have rivers. These rivers, as they move along, they carry out all the minerals and they deposit it along the banks of the rivers. So that soil is alluvial soil and it is very fertile. It is suitable for the growth of plants, crops. The coastal plains of Tamil Nadu mainly is fed by the rivers. So alluvial fans are found here. So districts of Tanjavur, Nagapattinam, Kadalur, Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari has alluvial type of soil. Sometimes in the interior of Tamil Nadu also has rivers. Those rivers also deposit the alluvial minerals in the banks. Those areas also have alluvial soil. Black soil is made up of the weathering of igneous rocks. And this is also a fertile soil. Since the color is black, it is called as black soil. This is best suited for the growth of cotton. Sometimes it is called as cotton soil also. This is found in Coimbatore, Madurai, Virudhunagar, Tirunelveli and Thoothukudi. Red soil is a very important soil that is found in Tamil Nadu. Nearly some 2/3 of the area of Tamil Nadu is covered by red soil. They are found mostly in the central districts of Tamil Nadu. So, Sivagangai and Ramanathapuram districts have red soil. Laterite soil is formed by the intense leaching. So, it is found in parts of Kanjipuram, Tiruvallur and Tanjavur and some parts of Belgris. Saline soil is found in the coastal regions, that is in the Coromandel coast. The name saline is derived from the word salt, because the soil is salty because it is along the coastline. It is called as saline soil. Along the coast of Tamil Nadu, we have a very good coast. So along the coast of Tamil Nadu, saline soil is found. But tsunami has affected these coastal areas. So the saline soil has been deposited, or it has been moved to the different parts. Next, we are going to focus on the topic soil erosion. Soil is eroded by various factors. It may be cyclones, floods. So, when the soil is eroded, it reduces the fertility of the soil. Further, it affects the agriculture of the soil. And you know, soil is a non-renewable resource. Once it is used, it takes a long time to get it renewed. Soil is eroded by many factors, by wind, water and other factors. So, it is very important for us to conserve soil. If we don't have fertile soil, we cannot grow crops. So, we should try to prevent soil erosion by planting trees. That prevents floods from moving the soil from one place to the other. Natural vegetation in Tamil Nadu refers to all the forest cover we have. And you know, we have hills and mountains. So, a wide variety of fauna and flora are found in Tamil Nadu. The total forest cover of Tamil Nadu is very low. So, according to the Tamil Nadu State of Forest report, nearly some 26,281 kilometer of the state has the forest cover. The forest types in the states vary from different, it's classified into different types: tropical evergreen forest, montane temperate forest, tropical deciduous forest, mangrove forest, tropical thorn. So it is classified based on the different characteristics. The first one is tropical evergreen forest. It is found in regions where there is heavy rainfall. It is a dense multi-layered forest. Mostly it is found in the western slopes of Tirunelveli, Kanyakumari, Nilgiris and Coimbatore districts. The trees that are found here are cinnamon, Malabar, ironwood, jack, crepe myrtle. And up in this tropical evergreen forest, we have the semi-evergreen forest of the subtropical climate that is found in the eastern Ghats. So, these regions, Sherburayan, Kollimalai and Pachamalai, are famous for this semi-evergreen type of forest. And in these forests, we have specified the trees like Indian mahogany, teakwood, jack and mango. Mountain temperate forests are found in Anaimalai, Nilgiris and Palani Hills at a height of 1000 meters. They are also called as sholas. These trees are evergreen, usually very short. So the types of trees found here are Nilgiri champa, rose apple with slitsi. The next one is the tropical deciduous forest. These lie in the margin of the semi-green and the tropical evergreen forests. They shed their leaves during the dry season, unlike the evergreen forest. These trees reach up to a height of 30 meters. So some of the trees found here are kapok, kadamba, women's tongue, axlewood. And here, bamboos are the most important ones found. Bamboo trees has varied uses, furniture and for construction purpose, bamboos are used. And these tropical deciduous forests are economically very important, because all the forest products from these used for commercial purpose. The next one is the mangrove forest. Mangrove forests are found in the coastal areas. Mangrove forests have a very good adaptation because of its moderate height and leathery leaves. That is the adaptation mangrove forests have. It is adapted to serve in the tidal mud and the salt water. These are found mostly in the coastal areas, river deltas and the tails of islands and in the sea faces. So these have trees have special adaptations to survive in the tidal and the sea coast. Otherwise, the soil will be eroded. The trees that are found here are white mangrove, wild jasmine. Pichavaram, Vedaranyam, Thoothukudi are the important places that have mangrove forests. These mangrove forests are very important. They play a very important role. They prevent in the coastal erosion. They play a major role preventing the coastal erosion. Because always the sea waves keep moving, the tides remove all the soil from the coast. So these mangrove forests prevent coastal erosion. It is also protecting the coral reef and also the seagrass meadows from being smothered in the sediments. The next one is the tropical thorn forest. It is found in places where there is very little rainfall. And they are found at an altitude of 400 meters height. The common trees are acacia, neem and palm. Shrubs are also found in the tropical thorn forest. These forests are found in the areas of Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram, Virudhunagar and some parts of interior Tamil Nadu. Next we move on to the wildlife. Now, Tamil Nadu has many plains, plateaus and hills. So, it has a variety of animals and birds, reptiles that live in Tamil Nadu. Apart from that, hills are an ideal refuge for elephants, bisons, tigers, deers and other wild animals. So, in Tamil Nadu, there are many wildlife sanctuaries that preserve all the animals in their natural habitats. So, we have Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, Gulf of Manna Biosphere Reserve, Agassiz-Malay Biosphere Reserves. So we have a varied climate, landform and resources. So it makes our state very distinct among all the other Indian states. So availability of resources, availability of all these make it an ideal place for all the animals and birds to live. So it is the duty of every individual to preserve all these animals and birds we have in our state. Next, we move on to the topic natural disasters. Now, what is a disaster? It's a natural disaster. So, a sudden natural catastrophe that causes great damage to or loss to lives and properties is called as a disaster. And usually human beings are not prepared when these disasters occur. So, the government has taken some measures to make the people aware of all these natural disasters, how to prevent them, what to do before, during and after all these disasters. So, according to the United Nations office, we have the disaster risk reduction. So, it is called as UNDRR. It is a concept and practice of reduction or reducing the disaster risk through systematic efforts to analyze and reduce the casual factors of the disasters. First of all, human beings are exposed to them. How to come out of it? What are the preventive measures? All that we are going to learn in this topic. Now, human beings are vulnerable and they are exposed to all these natural disasters. So, how to reduce all these, when people are exposed to all these hazards, lessening the vulnerability of the people and the property, wise management of land and the environment, and the initial step, preparedness, what to do when a disaster happens, and the early warning before any disaster occurs. All this we are going to focus in this topic. So, when we are going to discuss about all these disasters, we are going to learn what are the measures we are going to adopt before, during and after the disasters. Now, what are some of the disasters that occur in Tamil Nadu? Landslide, flood, cyclone, drought, fire accident, tsunami and earthquakes. So, for all these disasters, we are going to learn what we are going to do before, during and after. What are the measures to be adopted? So, what is a landslide? It is a collapse of a mass of earth or rock from the mountain or a cliff. So, landslide occurs because of that. Water is the most common trigger. In the hills and mountains, waters are the main source to make the soil loose. So, a rock or the mud slides, so landslides occur. Nilgiris in Tamil Nadu is identified as one of the most vulnerable districts of the country because always landslides occur there. So, the other regions which are prone to landslides are Palani Hills and Coimbatore. Now, what are the risk reduction measures that should be adopted before, during and after? So, first of all, people should be aware of the landslides that is going to occur. They should stay alert and they should always monitor the news of what is happening. They should listen for any unusual sounds or the moving of debris, boulders knocking, and immediately they should move on to a safe place. This is before. Now, after a landslide, what the people should do? Stay away from the area, listen to the radio or television for all the emergency information, watch for the flooding, and they should see how far the landslide has occurred, how to move away to safe places. Otherwise, they also can help the people who are trapped during the landslides without entering the direct area where the landslide has occurred. The next disaster is a flood. Flood is a common one that happens in the coastal areas of Tamil Nadu. So mainly during the northeast monsoon, floods occur in Tamil Nadu. So what are the risk reduction measures? So before a flood, people should know about relief centers, evacuation routes, keep emergency phone numbers and important information, and try to move on to the higher grounds when floods occur. During the floods, people should be quick, keep safe, and ensure that the children and elderly people move away to the safe places. We should turn off all the electrical appliances, gas, before leaving the area, and we are not supposed to drive during the flood times. We have to stay away from the power lines or the broken power transmission cables and keep away from the flood water. Now, after the floods, we should make sure whether the area is clear without water. Make sure there are no electrical poles that has been on the ground there. And we should wear the appropriate dress before cleaning the house, which is necessary to clean the contamination. Cyclones are common in Tamil Nadu. So these coastal regions are hit by the tropical cyclones during the northeast monsoon, and it causes a lot of damage to both to human beings and to properties. Based on the cyclone hit areas, Tamil Nadu is divided into high, very high, medium, low, and very low cyclone prone zones based on the intensity of the damage it causes. So before a cyclone, what are the things to be done? Ignore rumors, stay calm, and don't panic. Keep your mobile phones charged, ensure safety, listen to the radio or watch TV or the newspapers for weather updates. How far the cyclone intensity is, how many days it was going to be raining and all that. Then keep all the valuable documents and personal things safely. Secure your house, don't leave any sharp objects loose. If you have animals, keep all the animals also safe. Fishermen should keep a radio set with extra batteries. Keep boats and rafts tied up safely because they are not supposed to venture out in the sea during the cyclones. During the cyclone also, we have to switch off all the electrical appliances, keep all the family members safe. Try to help your neighbors, and please don't go out during the cyclone. Now, after the cyclone, people have to remain safely in the drier areas and wait till the instructions are given for them to move from that place. They are strictly avoid loose electrical wires, and there may be other animals or snakes or carcasses that are lying around or floating around. So people should be aware of all this. Immediately report to the authorities. The next one is drought. The interior areas of Tamil Nadu faces drought. So very dry areas. Tamil Nadu doesn't get rain always from both the monsoons. So during the southwest monsoon, the interior of Tamil Nadu is very, and sometimes even the northeast monsoon also fails. So what happens? there is a deficit of rainfall. To manage this deficit, rainwater harvesting is very important. Water conservation method is also should be done very strictly. The next one is fire accident. Tamil Nadu is in the tropical area, so some areas experience very dry climate. So because of this, high temperature is experienced, so forest fire occurs. The leaves in the tree become very dry and they catch fire. The entire forest area is destroyed. Mainly it occurs in the deciduous forest and in the thorn forest. Deciduous forest and the thorn forest, because they are very dry. The leaves are very dry. Now, what to do before? Now, we have to separate our home. Suppose if we are near the forest area, follow all the local fire and building codes. Keep all the trees and the plants trimmed so that they don't outgrow. Use approved fire resistant materials. Make evacuation plans and with the family members, try to go out and keep safe. During the fire accident, listen to the radio, watch TV, read the newspapers and be alert or keep updating yourself. If there is adequate water, please fill it with buckets of water. Turn off the gas and all the electrical appliances. Now, after the fire, we have to move cautiously. Make sure that the place is safe for to enter your home. It may be. Make sure that all the embers of the fire is because it flare-ups may occur. It may not have been burnt. So check all the ground for hot spots and check the roof whether there are sparks and embers. The next one is tsunami. Though tsunami is not occurring commonly in Tamil Nadu, once we have been affected by tsunami, that is in the year 2004. So Tamil Nadu has been alerted since then. So before a tsunami, people in the coastal areas should make sure that we are safe. So government usually gives warnings. So people are given warnings well beforehand. So people should return to safe places or to higher grounds. How to develop emergency plans? Make sure all the people and the properties at home to make sure it is safe. During the tsunami, take your getaway kit. Don't very far. Immediately start moving to a higher ground. So upper story of the building, or climb on to a roof, then grab a tree or all the floating objects. Never go to the shore to watch the tsunami. And after the tsunami, continue watching the TV and make sure be updated. Check yourself for injuries. Try to get first aid and help others. India is a vast country and it experiences many earthquakes in different periods. People are not prepared for the earthquake. So generally high risk zones of the country are located in North India and in central parts. The state of Tamil Nadu is located in the moderately low risk zone. So during an earthquake, try to take cover under a strong table or any furniture. Remain under cover until the shaking stops. After the earthquake has stopped, try to avoid roads, bridges that might have been damaged by the earthquakes. So we have seen in this lesson about the climate, soil, natural vegetation, the different types of soil, the forest types, and about the disaster and different types. And for the management of the disasters in the state, following forces are organized and in service. The first one, State Disaster Management Authority. and in the districts also, district magistrates, they have organizations to help the people out during disasters. So with that, we come to the end of the lesson.